Hello. So now that we have done with the UI and styling of the website, but now what we are seeing on the browser of our website is the static data. We have hard-coded all that data on ourselves. So that is what we are like looking at the browser. But we don't want that to happen because we can't just rely on the static data, hard-coded data for the rest of our lives. Like whatever we have coded inside this, we can't rely on that because right now our website is completely static. There's no dynamic thing in that. So it's static, whatever we coded, it's reflecting that as simple as that. But no, we want to make our site dynamic and we want to get the details of the weather, of the city we type and of the keyword we type. That keyword should be sent to the endpoint and the data should be fetched from the API, right? So that is how the site will become dynamic. So that we have to make. So in the previous thing, we child a component and everything was done, but that was also important. Now we want to do the API work. So this is very important. Before that, I'll teach you some things before getting into the main API. So we, as you know, we have captured the keyword which the user has typed in the search box in this search term variable. Okay, so now we want to send this variable to the endpoint and the data will be received and all that work will be done. Okay, so for that we need to add functionality to the search button because now when we click this button, nothing happens. Nothing actually happens. So we want to add an on click on this function. This is an on click function. So let me just explain what is on click. OnClick is a function which triggers whenever we click that particular element in which it is embedded. All right. So right now it's in this button which is OnClick, and we have called this OnClick function here. So it will trigger as soon as we click this button. All right. So inside this, there it expects a function which needs to be executed on clicking this button. Okay. So right now we don't have any function, but we will create. So let me just name it get weather info. Get weather info. This will be the function which will be calling as soon as the user hits the search button. Okay, but before moving on to that part, we want to clear some of the things here. Now we are going to use the use effect hook. Okay, next we will be looking at the async functions in JavaScript, and for that, for the async functions, you need to know the promises, and we will also be looking at try and catch. What is try and catch? So we'll be looking at these things. So these are the things which we'll be looking further to call the API and to fetch the data. So if you don't know about this, if you are a beginner to JavaScript and React, so I'll just tell you the basics of all this one by one. And if you already know and you are a basic to intermediate level, but still you need some clarification, so that will be cleared in this demonstration when I'll be teaching what is what. All right, so first of all, we'll take a look at the use effect hook. So as the other hooks use as the use state and use memo, something like other, there are so many hooks. So use effect is a really, really important hook. Now it's important, but what does it actually do? So we'll see what does it do. First of all, you need to import it here along with the use state from the React. And then we will see what it does. So let me just tell you how to write the use effect hook. First of all, you need to call it here. That's fine. But now let me explain you the syntax of the use effect hook. So for that, you need to write use effect wherever you are calling this use effect. So it expects a function inside this. So you will write a fat arrow function here. So if you don't know fat arrow function, this is the fat arrow function, and this is a dependency array here. All right, So now let me explain you one by one where you write what and what is what. Okay. So inside this use effect hook, here is what you write the actual code, like any function here, like whatever you need to like render or something like that. So here you write that stuff. And this is the dependency array. So like dependency array is responsible for running this effect, like how many times this effect needs to run and inside and the function inside it this needs to be executed. So this dependency array is responsible for that. For example, if I put here any variable, so like here we have search term. So in place of search term we might be having another variable. So or that or any, like for example, if I just put search term here. All right, so now whatever is inside this use effect hook, whatever the function is inside this, that function will be executed so many times. How many times? As many as times this variable will change its value. Did you get it? Let me tell it once again. The function inside this use effect will be executed the number of times this variable changes. So if this changes one time, so this will just run once, the function will run once. And if it changes, like whenever it changes, so this will be updating, this function will be executing. Okay, so inside this there can be any code you can write, any function you can write, that is up to you, and we'll take a look at it in the further things. So now the main thing which needs to be kept here in mind is this variable which is responsible for executing this function. All right, so now I hope it's clear. As simple as that, very very simple. This is a function and this will be rendered when it is this will be rendered whenever this variable changes its value. And what if we leave it empty? What if this dependency array is empty? So that means that whatever the function is there inside this use effect hook, that function will be executed when we reload the window, when we refresh the page. Only then, only that time, once this effect will run and the function inside this will be executed. That's all. After that, this function will not be executed and use effect will not work. But if you put any variable here and then the variable is like changing, so as it changes, this function will be executed accordingly. Okay, so that is why this is known as the dependency array. That's why we call it dependency array, because this use effect and the function inside this is dependent on this array, is dependent on the value inside this array. So I hope this is clear to you. So next we'll be using this use effect as we change the name of the city. As soon as we change the name of the city, we want things to get changed, right? We like, for example, if the variable is Delhi, which is passed, the search term is Delhi maybe. So when we are in Delhi, when the weather is showing of Delhi, so the weather of Delhi will be different. And when the search term is equal to Mumbai, so the weather of Mumbai will be different. So like different functions need to be executed, right? Like when then we'll be needing the different icon for, like in Delhi it's raining, so we'll be getting the rain icon. And if in Mumbai it's cloudy, so we'll be needing a cloud icon. So according to this variable, this function will execute, right? So now I hope you understand what is the use effect hook. This is the basic thing. Then you can go ahead and check on this React documentation, React.js documentation, official documentation. There they have given in very much detail what is the use effect hook. Just go it through once and you will have the complete understanding of the use effect hook. So next we'll be taking a look at the async functions. In the next video we'll be looking at the async functions and the promises. So see you in the next video.